Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Willardson. Welcome to Trust Implants. Today we want to talk about who's a candidate for implants or what is the typical patient. So I love this topic because, well, first of all, every case is unique to themselves. Every patient comes with different challenges and different scenarios that we have to treat and deal with as we're navigating through the case. But let's talk about the typical patient, you know, somebody who is either lost or is losing their teeth, or their teeth are falling out due to periodontal disease, or they've broken down teeth from bruxism or just wear and tear. Patients who've lost their molars and now all of a sudden the forced transition is all in the front of the jaw. So there's lots of different scenarios, but let's take a look at a couple of different cases and look at, this is a, to me, I would consider a very typical case here at Trust Implants. And so you'll notice here the patient has a lot of decay. There's decay underneath all of his crowns. He had a full mouth reconstruction. So he had crowns done about 5 years ago, and then, you know, somehow ended up in my office with this situation, and about every few months he'd have a tooth break off, and with it was the tooth was inside the crown, and then the crown would pop off, or would be, the tooth is actually snapped off. Half of the root is in the gum or in the bone, and the other half is in the crown. That's very common and can be a scenario that is common amongst some individuals. Now, so this is kind of a typical situation where we've got a lot of decay. If we were to look at the bone itself and the root structure, everything below the gum line, it's actually would be relatively sound. But because there's nothing to hold on to, there's no tooth structure to build a crown to, it was deemed necessary to extract all of his teeth. And so that's what we did. He's a young guy, but had some issues in his life and now wants to get everything fixed up, restore his confidence, restore his smile, restore his ability to chew and eat. And so we were able to help this young man, and was quite a great story and transformation. And so this is his before photo. This is his x-ray. So you can see here all of the lower front teeth are just broken off at the gum line. So surgically, what we have to do is go in and remove the remaining root tips and then place our dental implants. And so this is our before x-ray image. This is the prosthesis that we had fabricated for him on the bottom, the after. So we have 6 dental implants. We don't do all on 4 here. We do all on 6 at least. And so we get a nice even implant distribution, which, what does that do? The load distribution is favorable to the position of the implant. And so here is the final x-ray, and you can see here we've got 6 implants on the lower, and then on his upper we ended up doing 8 implants and kind of broke the bridge up in different sections, so it's not all one piece. Our goal here is, you know, once a patient has, when we take them from having teeth, like in this case, even though they were broken down, he still had some teeth, he could still chew, to edentulous, where we extract the teeth and place implants, that's a big adjustment. So what I try to do is make that adjustment as close to natural as possible. So, and we treatment plan our cases here just like that. So we try to keep the case, you know, when we pull the teeth out, we want to transition the new bridge and the placement of the implants to match what was removed or what his existing teeth were like as much as possible. And so for that reason, it's hard for us to quote a fee over the phone because every case is so unique. And so so this is the after photo. This is the upper, and notice we've got 8 implants in the upper jaw. So I have a section here, a section here, section here, and section here. So 4 sections, and it's really hard to tell, and even if you were to take a look in his mouth, that those are dental implants. Versus like an all-on-4 prosthesis where you have the plastic and the titanium framework and you only have 4 implants, you retract those cheeks away or look inside the mouth, and you know right away it's just basically a screw-in denture on top of four implants. And so, you know, we here at Trust Implants, we want to tailor each treatment plan according to the most ideal scenario for the patient. And there are patients who have maybe been in dentures for many years that have lost a lot of bone that this prosthesis or this scenario may not work on. So we try to custom tailor for that scenario. Another thing that they do in these large big box all on four practices is they'll reduce the bone and do what's called an alveoloplasty and level off the bone. And we do minimal alveoloplasty, meaning we hardly take any bone away because we want to maintain that and maintain how it felt prior to losing those teeth and keep that as close to their pre-existing situation to match the post after the surgery situation and match that up as close as possible. And that's what we did here for this patient. And take a look at the after smiling shot. You know, that just looks natural. His face is very relaxed. The color is very, just matches his skin tone, his lips. Notice the incisal edge, the edge of the tooth where it falls. There's the wet, dry line on your lip. These are details, but it's important. If you're going through this process, it's important to understand exactly what's happening. Unlike if you were to go buy a new car, you can go and touch the car, you can smell it, you can drive it. In this case, you can't do that. You're kind of just trusting the doctor that he's going to provide you with the very best materials, prosthesis, design, and long-term solution that's possible. And that's exactly what we do here. And so notice we've done that in this case. It looks very natural, very relaxed. And then here's his after photo. And so, it was a pleasure working with this patient and being able to take him through the process, because he too had a lot of questions when we started. He didn't know what the outcome was going to be. He didn't know how much pain was involved or no pain. He didn't know. I mean, there's so many unknowns. And that's unfortunately the nature of going through this process. There's a lot of unknowns, but we can arm ourselves with information to kind of bring the unknowns down a little bit. But and again, at some point, you just have to trust the doctor that's doing the work, that they're going to use the best materials, best implants, best graft material, and the best prosthesis to establish a scenario that feels the most natural according to your situation. That's another reason why we don't do any removable, implant-retained removable dentures, snap-in dentures, or hybrids or all-on-fours. We don't do those cases. If you're going to go through a procedure like this, you don't want to have the implants and then have teeth that come out. It defeats the entire purpose. Plus, you get really frustrated because the parts and pieces that attach the implant to the denture wears out quickly. So I stopped doing snap-in implant dentures, well, actually after I came out of my residency at Loma Linda University. I just found in private practice the cost you don't save that much is my point. You don't save much considering the headaches that you end up with after you've already paid for it and you're having to you're in the dental office all the time replacing these parts and pieces because they wear out. If you can imagine taking a denture on and off every day, even for 1 year, that's a lot of wear and tear, and the parts and pieces just cannot handle it. So we lean towards just a fixed bridge, whether it's a zirconia bridge or there's different types of materials that we can use, ideally zirconia on six implants. And we keep our costs down enough to where everybody can afford to do these procedures. And again, we custom tailor the treatment plan to the needs of the patient to try to mimic their teeth that they lost. Okay, so here we have a CAT scan of our patient, the case that we were showing earlier. So when I talk about, custom tailor treatment planning per the needs of each individual, because every mouth is totally different. And when I say that, when I look at the sinuses, or if I look at where is the what we call the inferior alveolar nerve, the posterior maxillary sinuses, what teeth have to come out. There's a lot of variables, and for that reason it's tough to quote a fee over the phone, simply because it's just, without an x-ray, it's impossible to know what exactly we're doing. We give the very best price possible, but the very best materials that are available today. So that is, what we're doing here at Trust Implants. So let's take a look at this case here. So to kind of orient ourselves, this brown line is the horizontal plane, the green line is the cross-sectional or sagittal plane. And so, this patient, all of the lower teeth have decay, the upper teeth are broken off and have decay, the crowns that he had done about 2 years ago, decay under each crown. So all of these teeth have to come out. And so, the way that we design and start to build these cases starts here. We start to look at, all right, so where do I need to graft and regenerate or build the bone? And, where is it that I have sufficient bone that I don't need to do as much bone grafting? We will just go ahead and start placing the implants and, identifying landmarks of anatomy. And then, we just go through and we can treatment plan this whole case, based on what the patient currently has at this time. And so, I won't bore you with all these details, but you can see here, I have all of the information that I need to give him back the smile that he has come to me for. And so, this is an important tool in my practice so that I can properly give the patient the most ideal aesthetic and functional prosthesis when everything is said and done. And so, it's a great tool that we have here, and that we use the very latest technology, latest techniques, latest surgical techniques, the most recent, latest implant designs and materials, the Straumann BLX implant. I can really, get down to the very details on these cases so that the patient ends up with the very finest prosthesis that will last them the rest of their life. So take a look at the after CAT scan of our patient, who we've removed all the teeth, we've grafted the sinuses, we've placed all of our implants, and we are in the process of fabricating the bridge or the prosthesis, which we've actually already done, but this CT scan was taken prior to that. And so, you can see now I have the implants in the most optimal position for the most optimal restoration to replace his teeth that he lost. And so the distribution of implants and the design of this case is, it's important that we can, anticipate what is the outcome when we're doing these cases. Because if we don't, a lot of times, and I see this in my practice, patients that have come from outside and they've had implants just placed in the most random places or really extreme weird angles, and we have to try to fit the teeth around the placement of implants, it's not ideal. And of course we can do it, but it's not ideal. So it's best to come in without having to deal with those sort of things. And so, and you can just see here, as we look at the this view here, the distribution is very even. And then if we look at the final photo of his case, you can see that every implant falls right where the tooth needs to end up. So anyways, we had great success with our patient here, and it's fun to do these cases because it is amazing to restore their confidence and their smile and their ability to just feel normal again. So here at Trust Implants, in reality, it's like, each of my patients are kind of part of my family, and we treat every single person that way. And because it is a big commitment both on the patient's part and also on our part, these cases have to last them the rest of their life. And so as a result, we use the very highest quality materials both in the teeth and implants and graft materials, as well as surgical techniques. So, it really is, we are family with all of our patients, and it's a wonderful thing. And so this is a final photo with our patient here, who really we've had a pleasure of working on. And So I'm Dr. Willardson, and thank you for watching, and stay tuned for more information on dental implants and implant reconstruction.